Hashima Mashati, with Dashiwa Russell, Red Carpet News TV, Canada's. Yoshiki, if I can start with you and speak in English now, please.
Okay. I thought you were speaking Japanese. I mean,
a little.
Great on Japanese. Yeah.
Yoshiki-san, obviously, this is a film that in part documents some of the physical and emotional pain that you've gone through in your life. Do you feel that is an important and essential part of being a truly great artist?
Well, it's kind of ironic, you know, for me to create the art. Sometimes this kind of pain might be necessary. It's, somebody asked me, if your father was still alive, did you become a rock musician? I would say no. Probably I've still playing classical music. Because of my father's death, I found out about rock and then jumped into this rock and roll music scene. So it was a really sad event, but all those things kind of made me.
It's a very brave thing for you to work with Stephen this intimately and share so much of yourself. Was there any particular memories, any particular experiences that the process of making this film brought back to you most powerfully?
Yes, of course, like my father's death, my friend's guitar player, bass player's death, my friend vocalist brainwashing process and everything. The first time my agent approached me about creating this documentary film, I said, there's no way I can open that door to memory. Too sad to go back there. But eventually people start telling me this film may be able to save people's lives. So that was a great reason for us to start. So that's how we decided to create this film.
And of course, you need to have a lot of trust in your filmmaker. What was it about Stephen that made you think he was the right man to go on this journey with?
I mean, I saw several documentaries, film Stephen has done. That was amazing, you know, just great image and everything, how he captured that kind of story. Also, he didn't know anything about Japan. I thought that was perfect. Because I want director to find out our story while we are filming.
What do you think makes Yoshiki's work so unique and so important of exploring in the way this film does?
It's kind of hard to put into words. I mean, a lot of it just came down to a feeling, you know? I mean, it was total immersion. We kind of met, very brief discussions, almost no preparation, and within days I was side stage watching X Japan performing in Yokohama, getting ready to come to play Madison Square Garden. And I've seen a million rock concerts. I've never been in shock the way I was standing on the side of that stage, watching them perform, seeing the reaction from the audience. It was just a kind of intensity of energy and audience artist feedback that I was feeling physically. I'd literally never seen anything like it. It was a total shock. I mean, it was unbelievable. That alone, that like energized me and kind of started us off on this process. And I knew I needed to get some of that spirit into the film somehow. It kind of all started there. I don't think I've completely answered your question, but that's kind of how it all started.
Yoshiki-san, this is a film that chronicles your very varied career and achievements. I'm curious, looking back at all of those with the hindsight of this film, is there anything that you are most proud of in terms of the work you've done, one piece of work or one element of your career which you feel best defines you?
Good question. When I composed the piano concerto for Emperor of Japan, that was kind of my turning point. Because at that time, I was kind of like, I was about to quit music. Because, you know, when I started thinking about music, that led me to memory of Hide, you know, the guitar player who passed away, Watoshi, you know, my childhood friend. So, but it was so, like, strange in a great way. It's just, I got offered to write that kind of, like, music. It's like, almost there's a, like, it's just an offer I can just say no.
Mm-hmm.
So I almost no choice to going back to the music. Then, at that time, I had a crazy, like, feeling, like, so angry, so sad. But at the same time, you know, there are happy memory of Action Man as well. Like, so basically, I was asked to write 10 years anniversary of Emperor of Japan. So which is, like, 10 years of Japan, basically. So I started looking back, you know, my history or, like, Japan's history. So then I made that melody through my emotion. Then I kind of, like, that song actually was supposed to dedicate to Emperor of Japan, but also helped me as well.
One of the things this documentary captures is the transformative effect that your work has had on Japanese music culture in general. I'm curious, what do you think the future of Japanese music is, and what role do you hope personally and through the band to be playing in that?
Mm. Yeah, Japanese music seems kind of like, how do you say, a melting pot. It's like, you know, you put everything into it.
So let's go.
Yeah, it's like anime music, hip-hop, rock and roll, punk rock, EDM, just, you know. Japan's kind of like that too. We were kind of a hard rock band, but we were influenced by David Bowie and Sex Pistols and all those punk rock and some anime music. So I think it's really cool. You know, it's like Western music somehow kind of defined something we can categorize.
Mm-hmm.
But from Japan, probably you may. Like, baby metal is one of them, you know.
Yeah.
It's going to show up something like, yeah. You know, and categorize, you know, music. That's, I think it's really cool. I think it's going to be happening more and more, something like this.
Chris, of all the other musicians you've met, of all the other artists you've met, has there been one experience for you where you had that fan experience yourself, where you felt that excitement to meet another creator?
When I first met Kiss, you know, because Kiss is one of the reason we started. So yeah, it was so cool, you know. I was like, whoa, you know, actually I did the Kiss tribute album. I did piano concerto version of Kiss song called Black Diamond.
Mm.
So when I was working with Kiss, I was like, whoa, I'm working with Kiss. Like, that's cool. You know?
He looks really good in Kiss makeup too. Just
yeah.
Really good.
Yeah.
I can believe that. Have a very quick message to your fans, Yoshiki.
Yes. Thank you so much for being so supportive. We are here because of, you know, your support. This film was made because of your support. So, you know, we would like to keep on rocking to, you know, support you too.
Hi. Stephen, thank you so very much. Yoshiki-san, arigato gozaimashita.
Arigato gozaimasu.